Everything's cool, everything's fine. Leuk dat je weer kijkt naar deze aflevering. We zijn nog steeds in Abroad, waar onze gasten aan het jammen zijn. Dus laten we snel even gaan kijken.
Why did you actually come to the Netherlands?
So, you know, as an artist and a musician, I've lived in Texas. I was born in California, and then my parents got divorced. I've lived in Texas, for decades. My dad had two songs in the 60s, She's About a Mover, Mendocino. But by the 80s, he kind of was in that thing with Austin and Texas where I want to find something new. So he goes to Scandinavia,
okay.
And then gets a hit with Meet Me in Stockholm. It's like a... Meet me in Stockholm, baby, we'll mess around. Take a real slow boat to Helsinki town.
So sounds great.
Yeah, it's very, it's a really nice song. So he all of a sudden had a hit, and then he was over in Scandinavia for like 3 years. Yeah. So I just kind of took that same thing, I was getting a little bored of where I was at. Like any place, property taxes were my house I had. It was just going through the roof. And when I got a little bit of money, it was like, Shandon, this is what you've always wanted to do.
Yeah.
Do it. And I've been to Holland many times, 20, 30 times before I've moved here.
Okay.
And, I've toured here, and I've came here for vacation. So I lived here. I've came here many times, and I just was like, what would it be like to live here?
Yeah.
And my dad, I almost say, kind of greased the wheels because he's played Paradiso. He's played Milky Way here in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, and 90s. So he's played here a lot, and so he kind of greased the wheels, it's like I knew he had a little fan base. I just wanted something new, and it opened doors. I've got, after about 4 or 5, 6 months, I found these cool people here at Abroad, know, and really good team, really good guys.
Yeah, but I believe that if you're driven by passion, you don't want to stop, you want to go on.
Well, true.
Go on.
And sometimes though, people might think, I don't have the money's running out, or I don't have the passion anymore. Some people lose passion. So I came over here, and basically, so what I'm doing is I'm doing like a Sahm cover Sahm and my own originals. So I play a little bit of dad's music. I play my own. I've got an EP coming out February 22nd on Friendly Folk Records. Plug. No. And it's called Sahm cover Sahm. It's a 5-song EP that I recorded here at Abroad in Breda. So, and then I'm going to do my own original music in about, I'd say, June or July. But I've been doing, I've been writing, here's one of the riffs I've kind of been wanting to work on. It goes up. Wait, let me make sure I got it. Okay, so it goes. And I was trying to, so I'm saying, will you comfort me?
Sounds a bit mysterious.
In my time of need. Yeah, well, I think because it's dark, right?
Yeah.
The minor key.
I immediately have to add the thought about Soundgarden sound.
It actually does kind of like.
Something like that. A mysterious dark vibe.
Hold on, it does kind of sound like. Hang my head.
Yeah.
So what I want to do here is just, I'm going to be releasing that on the 22nd of February.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to start touring and getting as much groundwork as possible. I'm here for a few years or hopefully longer. If I can stay for 5, I can become, a citizen. So I just got to get working and keep, doing what I do. But, I'm here. I have an artist visa. So I'm here. I can play music. I can play music with other people. I can be on other people's records. I can, anything musically related, I can do.
Yeah.
So I can't go work at a bar back. Like my specific visa is a music artist visa.
So you have to do something.
Yeah, I can't just go work at a bar.
Yeah.
Now, so having said that, that covers a lot of ground, playing on people's records, getting paid to play, just all that, gigs. Mm-hmm. Recording, so that's really fun, and I've had a lot of fun since I've been here. It's opened up a lot of worlds for me, and I just like meeting people that are genuinely about it. Sometimes I know in America you have to question sometimes people's motivation or their agenda, like here with everybody I've met, like 98, 99.5, I can just feel like the agenda is because they love it. They're not, this isn't like a money making thing where they do it. Cause you know, America, it's like, it's everywhere now, but all about the dollar, all about the dollar. Here you kind of like a little bit more about the art. And then if it happens to make money, that's great. You know, like we all want to be successful. Mm-hmm. We all do. You'll never know when that strikes too. So be prepared. Here's what I do in a nutshell. I was drummer for the Meat Puppets. I played with Gibby Haynes from the Butthole Surfers. I've been drumming most of my life. But when I'm not in those really good drumming bands, I'm doing this.
When did you actually start playing guitar?
Oh, I started when, you know, probably in my 20s, because I had like just two strings around, like when I told you about the Eddie Van Halen.
Yeah.
I had a two-string guitar that was just laying around.
Two-string guitar?
Oh, it was like, I didn't know how to tune it. It was just laying around, and so I'd pick up these strings and just pick.
Okay.
And then one day I started. Anyways, it's better on electric guitar. It sounds a little bit better. It's harder to fret on these acoustics.
Yeah, with a bit of a gain.
But that's, you know, that's the kind of thing. So it just had two strings, and I would just bend and play notes, even though it was totally out of tune. I think it's just getting used to it. Even if you go, I know that's boring, but just kind of getting you used to it.
Yeah, the feel of it. Yeah.
Yeah, the feel of it.
And that's how I started drumming as well. I never really got a teacher, but I just
started.
Yeah, and just start slamming those things.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, that's exactly how you do it. Ba ba boom ba doom ba boom boom ba da ba ba doom ba, and then boom ba boom boom.
And eventually, it's going to sound good anyway. Just keep going, you know.
The more you apply it.
Yeah.
I'm not here to be my dad. I'm here to just pay a tribute to him and give you that Sahm vibe.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Dad had a voice that was very distinct and very powerful. So, you know, I'm not comparing things to anybody, but say if your dad was Freddie Mercury, right? Does it really matter how great your singing is? Because that guy had such a great, amazing voice. Mm-hmm. How do you compete?
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, that's the same thing. I'm not saying Dad had like the Queen voice, but he had such a distinct, such a rich, full tone in his voice that I don't even try to compete on that level. What I do is just give you that Sahm vibe, you know? So when we're playing, you know, he does it all, you know, because he's been doing it forever since he was 8. But I just give you the vibe, you know? I don't sing it perfectly, but I'll go, well, she was a-walking down the street, you know? But he'll sing it like, perfect, because he's been doing it for so long. Mm-hmm. I just want the passion, you know. I just want the passion. Hey. What I say? She's about to move up. She's about to play so. Well, you know I love you, baby. Oh yeah, what I say? I'm not concentrating on America right now. Like, I've done it, you know? I want to be here. I want to spread the Dad's music and my own music.
Are you planning to stay here for the rest of your life, or do you eventually want to go back to America?
No, have no desire. Have no desire. I want to see my friends.
Yeah.
But I don't want to live in America.
Not anymore.
They can have it. Okay. I'm not. Ready? I'm gonna sing. Take my picture off the wall. It don't matter to me at all. D, still eyes heading for a fall. Would you want me to crawl? Key to my heart. Give back the key to my heart. Give back the key to my heart. Here goes the D.
Yeah.
And let my love flow like Everybody hears music differently. Art is objective, subjective, whereas if you like it and you truly dig it, then you should do it. If people don't get it, you know, I mean, eventually you want them to, but don't worry about it. Don't be desperate. Don't sell yourself, but don't sell yourself desperately. Like, if you're good enough, your music will do the talking for you. That's what I say about great guitar players, you know, that are kind of uncool in the mind, but they play great.
I'm like, eventually, yeah.
Are kind of hard to get along with, but they're great players. Mm-hmm. I say, whether it's me or you, brag through your instrument. That's where I want to hear you brag. Not about, you know what I've done? I used to play in the meat pub. You know, it's like, I'll brag through my instrument and hopefully you'll go, he's had some season playing.
I find it much more impressive.
When it's like this, it is.
Yeah.
Because it's a one-on-one thing.
Yeah.
And I really enjoyed it for having you. Oh, yeah, we have a visitor coming in.
Sorry to disturb you. Wait, let me just come here.
We have a visitor coming in, so we're going to play around with him.
Yeah. I wish I could play guitar like you guys. Okay. Because I was listening and it sounded really nice. And
thank you.
It sounded like you had a nice conversation as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we did.
So, did you both enjoy it?
Yeah, of course, we did. Yeah.
I thought it was, and you know, it's what it all is about. It's about exchangement of ideas, and, you know, talking is a form of that, talking about your music, just because everybody's got a story when it comes to music.
And it's nice to see that you're both from a different culture, but still you have similarities and you still like similar things.
You know what
it is? Music.
It's called music.
Yeah. Music that connects.
Music connects everyone. It's a universal language. Doesn't matter their religion. Doesn't matter if you're about music, you've already got something in common. Just the way it is. Music is like, makes the world go round. If we didn't have art, if we didn't have music, this world would be really boring.
That's a nice ending.
And we
quote.
Wouldn't be talking about this. We would be talking about mathematics or something.
Well, true.
12 times 12 is. See, isn't that interesting?
True.
No.
But I want to thank you both guys for coming here to Abroad. And hopefully I will see you another time as well.
Yeah, and I wanted to say thank you guys for having us.
Yeah.
It's really, really nice to be able to share our experience. And I hope that the people that are watching and everything get inspired to do their own music.
Very
so
nice.
Whether it's Stijn or his band, you know, go support local music. It's really important.
That's how it thank is. Both, thank you for coming. And hopefully see you next time.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
thanks so much,
we
guys.
Had a great time. Thank you.
Great.
Guys,
cheers.
Thank you.
Did that work? Uh-oh.